All right, so what's the matchup?
In Reduke's testing, he did go from one ancestor up to two.
I think you guys should do Tron again.
Tron again?
Yep.
Now that we made these changes?
Yep.
See if that helps.
That's right.
Tron again, Tron again, Tron again.
Time's up, let's do this.
Go Tron again.
Modern testing. Sultai versus Tron. Update information. Man, I'm the only moderator in chat right now, guys. What is this? Expecting me to mod everything myself?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, that's fair. I can respect where you're coming from on that. I'm kind of the best moderator of all time. You are most welcome, sir. Let's bring this bad mamma jamma right there.
Did I just... Nope, it's out of the... Nope, there we go.
Okay, putting this guy back in.
Probably more chips, as I think they might be too loud.
Yeah. Probably. Slap this back into the roof of my blue eye control deck.
Yeah, people are talking about running hieroglyphs in this kind of deck too.
It's a very interesting card.
Yeah.
Also, you guys know you can get any condiments you want out of my fridge, right?
I did. Yep. Barbecue sauce.
Oh, okay. Except for that one.
Well, it's too late. You don't want it back.
I'm going to show you guys the ultimate way to eat a hot dog. Now, that's going to be the best YouTube video we've ever done. Okay, step one, you put some mayonnaise on it. You with me on this so far?
I'm listening.
Step two, a little bit of black. As we all know, black powder is the fundamental flavor.
Black powder?
Black powder? Black pepper?
I heard powder.
Ah. I heard powder too.
Then, you take a big old fork full of sauerkraut. You spread it all over your hot dog. And then you just pile it up. So much sauerkraut. More sauerkraut than dog.
More sauerkraut than bun, even.
And then you drink down that delicious mayonnaise sauerkraut black pepper juice that's dripping off the side. Guys, you're missing out. This is the pinnacle of hot dogs.
Maybe. For you.
Or how did Spectre eat his? With hard salami?
Yeah, the Bernard salami and sauce on it.
Honey mustard and hard salami.
I love it when you get hard salami on your hot dog. It's delicious.
Yum.
Anytime you can eat more than one meat at a time, you should take that opportunity.
Like a turducken.
Turducken, yeah. Or really, like, anytime you can cram together, like, even, like, really weird combos, like getting a double beef cheeseburger at McDonald's and putting a fillet of fish on it.
Or a pheasant quail squirrel. Hmm? Pheasant quail squirrel. I'm just making stuff up.
Cram rodents into...
Pheasant and quail are both birds.
Yeah.
Rodent of the sky.
There you go. I mean, I would try it. I'd be like, this seems like it could be all right, and I would eat it.
Pigeon, squirrel, mouse.
Maybe some voles. Get a vole in there.
A rabbit.
Bee rabbit.
I like rabbit jerky.
Roast M&M.
I'm all about rabbit jerky.
Alright, grudge match. Dinner. Low roll, double re-roll, triple doubles.
Eat this empty Rockstar can.
Whoa.
I put water in it.
That sounds like bleeding.
Yep. Seven.
Again.
Nine.
Oh, but I actually won this time.
My streak is over.
So this is one of the kind of things where, like, this deck views your deck as a rival, and your deck doesn't even know this deck exists.
Right.
It's like a really bad anime about playing Tron. I'd watch that anime.
just replace Gary Oak with Tron, which is Unalaq's face. And all his Pokemon are the Urza lands. And Ancient Strings.
Yep, I'm keeping this. Are you keeping yours? Alright.
Yes, I'm.
So, we're gonna crack that. And Thought Seize you. Give me some green mana.
Strings. Sphere. Stone. Stone.
Gotta take your stirrings.
Okay.
There it is. And then you get to take your turn.
Draw. Plant sphere. Go ahead.
This cracking it, Goyf.
Mm-hmm.
Getting watery grave, and you may go.
Untap, upkeep, draw. Mine. I'll say go.
Your cut. Untap. Draw. Not what I wanted to see.
Wait, that is too bad now.
Swing in for two. Pass you the turn.
Hey, your turn. Sacrifice. Sphere. Draw a card. Any of your hand. Doesn't matter. Untap. Upkeep. Draw a card. One coil with one flooding.
Yep.
Cast map.
Yep.
Go.
Dark Slick Shore. Snapcaster Mage, flashing back Thoughtseize.
Mine.
Yep. Taking one of those stones.
Yep.
And passing you the turn.
Untap. Upkeep. Crack map. ourselves a tower.
Mm-hmm.
Draw step. Light tower.
Mm-hmm.
Combat. Yeah.
Fuck.
Okay. Game six.
Yep.
And go ahead.
Hunt.
Draw.
Tracker.
Mm-hmm.
Land. Clue.
Yeah.
Pass the turn.
Yeah. Untap. Upkeep. Draw. Yeah, combat.
Yep.
Attack for six.
Trade.
Yep. Kill both. Gain six. Go to 30. I'll grab a few worms here in a second. For now. Death. Life. I'll grab things here. Play forest, tap for green, stirrings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Grab Karn. Seven, cast Karn.
Mm-hmm.
That's here. OCD.
They brought the kitten.
There it is. We're gonna two cards in hand.
Three cards.
Exile.
See,
double blue, double green. Double green. The shores. And go ahead.
You're not gonna attack me?
Hmm?
Not gonna attack me?
I already did.
Yeah. Okay, yes. Right.
Yep.
Turn. Yep. Okay.
That's the angry cat. How's this game going?
I'm going to lose because I didn't draw into anything good. We're going to trophy your Karn.
Lifelink death touch. Trophy Karn?
Yep.
Karn's trophy.
And then you get to go.
Worst.
Got land screwed early on.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw. Combat.
Yep.
Six.
Slip the lifelink. Push the lifelink. Take three.
Second main.
Yep.
For that. Nah, you got this one. Play tower. Not tower.
Way too late. Liliana. Give that minus two, minus one.
Okay.
Pass the turn.
Turn. Give it a fake counter.
Short.
Away. Go to my turn. Untap. Upkeep. Draw.
You don't like these?
Not just by itself.
Really?
Yeah.
Sanctum.
Yeah, I don't like a lot of cheese.
And then 3, 2 pops down.
Yep.
Each non-land permanent without a fate counter on it. Oh, yeah. And then attack 3.
One,
sorry. Go ahead.
Pastor.
Untap. combat. 3.
Block.
Yep. For the mine.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Boop. Scavengers. Pass turn.
Untap. Okay. Draw. Well, forest. Play it or tap it. Stirrings.
Yep.
Okay.
That was what I drew when I said way too late.
That's what kind of what I thought.
And then that was what I just drew. That turn. And I couldn't afford to crack that clue because I had to be responding.
Yep.
Now, feels like a lot of this time this deck is playing from a losing position.
Does it?
Yeah.
Like you're never ahead?
Right.
You're trying to run your opponent out of resources and then try to push forward with your plan.
Yeah, but it feels like a lot of the time it's me losing and then I get something to respond and then I respond and I respond and then I run out of responses rather than you running out of threats.
Things to do. Wow. I gotcha.
Having trouble with Tron.
Yep.
I think it's a hard matchup.
Yeah, I think it always will be.
Yeah, no matter what you do.
Yeah. Like I said, I think I have to get lucky to beat it.
So, I mean, I guess the real question is that enough to make you want to be on a different deck?
I don't know. Like, how prevalent is Tron going to be?
I think that's the real question, and it's a difficult one.
I think you'd want to play a deck that's has a. So at the moment, it's sort of a concession that. Game one, you're not going to do so well against Tron every time.
Those swaps is good.
And then it's how frequent that other deck, the deck that you're. Basically,
those swaps
giving up
to good.
Is. And I believe Tron is fairly frequent.
Yeah.
At least in the Portland meta that I can recall.
So then here's the question.
There's just so many decks.
Do we do this instead? I put in one extraction and keep Kalidus in. So these swapping for these.
Only one extraction?
Potentially. Like, it could be this going instead.
Well, yeah, true.
Or we could do one unmoored ego and two extractions. But I think unmoored ego might be better against the Tron matchup than the surgical extraction. And then the question is Kalidus better against Tron than surgical extraction? And the answer is probably yes, because of the worm. Because this defeats the worm. If
yep.
I can kill the worm.
If it gets when it gets exiled, it does not make the tokens.
Oh, that's right. I forgot to put it out this morning. Brian Matthews is doing his Dornbecker stream right now.
Nice.
Or is it Dornbecker or is it St. Jude's? Dornbecker, yeah. So after we're done streaming tonight, I'm going to host him. For zero viewers, probably. Unless we get really popular in the next couple of hours.
Oh, let's see how boss do. If they show up sooner.
Yeah. Or there's four in there, so they show up. You want to see it in your starting hand. You run four of them.
True enough. No. You want to play?
Yes.
Okay.
Against anything but Tron, this is a good hand.
Dang.
Yeah, I have no interaction, so I just lose.
I'm holding Fatties. No green source for scrying. No reliable way to get. Double look. Oh, it's fine. It was a star on top. I probably would have kept it. Excited for Warcraft 3 Remastered?
I'm extremely excited.
I am.
I never played it in the first place.
Well, good. You get to experience all the lore and backstory in HD textures and high resolution.
Really freaking excited.
Because it looked really bad 16 years ago.
Yeah. But I mean, how bad did it look compared to, like, StarCraft?
Well, considering it was 3D, low poly. Worse.
Oh, it wasn't. Because
it used
2D.
All in-game assets instead of all a bunch of CG renders.
Oh, because I thought StarCraft still looks pretty decent.
It does.
After all this time.
Original StarCraft?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It does.
Because Jessica and I play StarCraft 1 and not the StarCraft 1 remaster.
Yeah, we'll go with it.
Let's see if this can get there. Alright.
pass the turn. Pass the turn.
Go.
End of your turn. Crack that. Overgrown Tombling to play tapped.
There we go.
Do I want Overgrown Tomb? No, I don't want Overgrown Tomb. Breeding Pool into play tapped.
Ruby.
Boop, boop, boop. Draw that card. Blooming Marsh. Blue, black, green. Unmortigo.
Yep, response.
Yep.
Bust this for a, what's it called?
A power plant? Because I am naming power plant.
There's my hand. There it goes. There's the rest of the hand.
Tusk and a seer. Ow. Okay. Let's see if I can win it this time, though. Tron has been disabled again.
Surprise, white land, pull from eternity. Pacha!
No! Wasn't deep enough. I mean, like, no!
No! You better know.
Yep.
Drop. Okay. And that's it?
Yep. Okay. Yeah, I'm tapped out.
Ah.
I don't want to surgical your map.
Map. Mip. Forehest.
On the map, on the map, on the...
Stirrings.
Yep.
3, 4, 5. Ghost Quarter.
Alright then.
3 scrimes. Down to me. Play Sphere.
Yep.
Say go.
Boop. Weep. Blue to Delta. Pass the turn.
Crack Sphere. In the green. Untap, upkeep, draw. Play Forest.
So I like came to last time.
Cast the Thunder Seer.
Stroke the Seer.
Stroked. Go ahead. Reach out a Festival of Control spells in your
end of your turn. Correct that.
Yep.
This time we do get Overgrown too.
I like that one, Brandon. Looks good.
Yeah, I thought that one was pretty sweet.
Shouldn't Dredge be the new Dredge toy, though?
Which one is that? Fire Shrieker?
No, the
Shriek one.
Yeah, Fire Shrieker one.
The
chilled, chilling.
So can I give you a secret message about the thumbnails? They're actually a clue to a conspiracy that I'm aware of.
Oh?
Yeah.
What's this?
That only high-res images of magic cards can be found on pushed story cards.
Really?
Which isn't really a conspiracy. It just kind of makes sense.
Creeping Chill.
Creeping Chill, yeah.
Yeah, Creeping Chill.
But so since Creeping Chill is not a pushed story card, I unfortunately
don't have.
Well, that's not a very like highly noticed card because they just see it like people will wave it like trigger and then just throw it off the exile off screen.
Yeah.
Of the most powerful dredge tools, I'd say that one is Cathartic Reunion.
Well, and it also being a story card, I'm able to find good art of it to use.
Yeepers.
Okay.
And I mean, you get to see like 2/6 of the Gate Watch in one picture.
Yep.
So I think I have to get rid of the known threats.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know next turn you can drop a Thrag Tusk. I would have looked through your deck, so you brought in how many Thrags?
It's two.
Two Thrags.
Three, and you would have seen, what's your face back? Emrakul, Promised End.
Okay. Yeah, I think I just pass you the turn at this point.
Okay. Untap. Keep. Draw a card.
Do I hear a cat throwing up?
Possibly.
Maybe, but the cat's sitting on the donuts.
Yeah.
Cast it.
Stroke the tusk.
Tusk feels happy. Go ahead.
She looked like she was going to.
Untap. Draw.
I'm glad she didn't.
Thoughtsies.
Boy.
I mean, so Spectre, if you want to be able to beat Tron, there's a surefire way to do that at the Grand Prix. But you're not gonna like it.
Yeah, I'm not playing Burn.
You knew what I was going to.
Just play Burn.
I don't want to make my matchups worse against other decks.
Hey, Bert, just play Burn. Yeah, just play Burn against Tron. Yeah. Not RNA. Dang it, I can't. RNA, no, I refuse to play Burn. That's not what Burn sounds like.
We take out Karn.
It has been 23 years since since I last remembered what Burn sounded like. Karn, ha-cha.
And we play our land for the turn, and we pass it to you.
How old am I? Draw a card. Play land. Cast. Hot Knight.
Snapcaster Mage. Stroke it.
Stroked. One caress over that eyeball. Go ahead.
Okay.
What is your happiest five-word Magic the Gathering sentence?
End of turn? Sinks a relation? That's my favorite five-word sentence.
I like this one. Birthing pod is now unbanned.
That was close to what I was going for. Deathrite Shaman has been unbanned.
I'll be on the play. That's a nice, easy one.
Yep, that's pretty good.
Valakut, comma, the Molten Pinnacle.
Is banned.
Swing five.
Take five.
Trophy your quarter.
Sadness.
And then you may go.
I'll click yes.
Isochron. Reversal, Soul Ring, Tim.
Dramatic reversal, yeah.
On Isochron Scepter with Soul Ring and Prodigal Sorcerer.
That's a kill, yeah.
That's a really funny kill. I kind of want to build that just so I can kill somebody in Commander with an Isochron, or with a Prodigal Sorcerer.
You just build a 5-color deck that's all combo pieces.
Yeah.
And have like tons of overlap.
I don't get the combo.
So Dramatic Reversal is 2 mana, and it says untap all non-land permanents you control.
Okay. Now I understand.
Yeah. Oh, is that?
That's your go. Okay. I'm out of hand, out of tapped Mind. Out. Watch you draw the worm.
Scrying.
Yep. Here comes the Ghost Quarter.
Number two? What do you got?
It's in there.
There it is. Third card. Missed it. Play it. Do it now. Play stone. There you go. I'm tapped poorly for the Thought Seer attempt.
Yep. Did I just miss it completely?
Basic forest?
Yeah.
It's right there. When you're thumbing through, I was trying to just get a stop on it. What's with the lame forest? Where'd the other one go?
I don't like a white portrait forest.
Oh, was it a... Okay.
Yeah, it's an ugly forest.
It was the best forest.
No, it was white bordered.
It was the best forest. I mean, it's okay. You're allowed to be wrong. This is America, etc.
Swing two.
Yep.
Pass.
No tap. Okay. You want to hold that in your hand?
No.
In case you get the trackers?
No.
Draw track? No? Okay.
Because I don't want to draw more lands.
I agree. Castraggy.
Mm-hmm.
Trigger. Go.
Crack that.
Yep. I'm trying to also reduce your count by one. So.
Yep.
Never mind.
Oh,
no,
that was my extra.
Warcraft 3 is exciting, but I'm super stoked for this Diablo game.
Why are you lying?
That was quick. I just got outed fast.
Yep. What you can do now, sucker?
Be excited for the new Diablo game, of course.
Oh my goodness.
I mean, admittedly, here's the unpopular opinion. Blizzard has never made a bad game. So, yeah. Why would we assume they're going to start now?
They've made bad decisions with their good games, but never made a bad game.
And even when they make bad decisions with their good game, usually they turn out okay.
Way too late.
I mean, somehow they've managed to keep World of Warcraft going for, what is it on, like 14 years now or something?
Let's see, late 2004. Yeah.
We're going to extract your Karn.
Karn?
Yep.
Liberace.
So, I mean, they've made literally the only MMO that was successful this long. Because I don't think you can count really any MMO but WoW as being successful.
That's all of them.
Maybe Guild Wars 2. Do people still play Guild Wars 2?
No idea.
Like, I guess they might, but I don't know.
There you go, right?
Yeah.
That's it. Upkeep. Draw. Combat. 5.
Trade.
Jump?
Yeah. Trading for no damage.
Okay. This star.
Yep.
Go ahead.
Bloop. Bloop. I won't survive long enough. Pass turn.
Your turn. Fate counter.
Yep.
And also crack the star. Turn. Tap. Upkeep. Draw. Power. Drop star. Play star. Combat. 5. Go.
Thought erasure. That's not going to do anything for me. So, pass the turn.
Sack star.
Mm-hmm.
Draw a card. Untap. Upkeep. Draw. Combat 5. Stir it. 2, 3, 4, 5. Have a coil. Cast coil.
This deck just cannot beat Tron.
Was that the match?
Yep. Still haven't seen Bob, though. Which is strange, putting 4 in there. Don't see him in 2 games. Ego definitely helps against Tron, but it does not win the game.
Alright, what do I do now?
What would you guys like to have happen?
What do you think I should go against after all these changes?
What's in this? Oh shoot, we haven't done this yet.
What is it?
Storm. Blue red storm.
We did do that when you weren't here.
Ah.
We have blue red storm.
That's what I just found, yeah.
You played storm against me.
Did I really?
Yes.
I don't remember this.
It's part of the reason why we put Nimble Obstructionist in this deck.
So you could stifle storm.
Yes.
A grave shot, yeah.
Okay. So we're doing storm?
Sure.